Yo, what's up, guys? AxelandFoxNinja here, and we are back to the video. And welcome to How to Solve a 3x3 Rubik's Cube Beginner Method. It took me a while to figure this out, but ever since then, I've been able to solve it like 15 times, literally, and all that stuff. But yeah, this is about this. Also, I should probably, turn off this top audio, yeah. So yeah, my friend literally in real life, he literally wrote down all of this, like a ton of it, and I eventually just read it and learned how to solve it. So I'm teaching you guys how to do it. It's the beginner method. Hopefully he's gonna teach me the advanced method, or I'm pretty sure he just told me to look up because he's kind of a jerk in real life, not gonna lie. Hope he doesn't see this. Oh, whatever. So yeah, I'm just gonna be starting off with each step and stuff, so let's get started with this. All right. Step one, the white cross. This is how. All right, so how you solve it is, okay, literally this chair squeaks every 5 seconds. It's so annoying. But anyways, what you're trying to do is you're trying to get the here. It's so hard to angle it right here. You're trying to get white cross like angled like. Oh, this is so hard to show. Okay. Whatever. I guess I could go like this. All right. So you see this white part right here. You have to try and get it like this, starting it off, and then like here. It's better because of the lighting. And then I have to make sure it has to be aligned pretty much. So is this Rubik's Cube in the camera? Jeez. So like, for instance, that has to be green and white there and all along there. All right. So starting with it. This is probably one of the easiest ones. Not the easiest one to explain on camera, though, I'm not gonna lie. But I promised myself I'd make this video eventually, so yeah. Starting it off with. And also, this one is terrible, there are way better ones. So, okay, we have this one. Like, okay, this is it, like, right here. See? See? Yeah. I got that part done, and now. Let's do the green side. Oof. There we go. There we go. I also got the orange side because it was there and I could do it. But I'm gonna throw that one out there. Oh, for crying out loud! That is so annoying. I literally keep getting parts of the next step in that. Oh, great. No, I have to. Yeah, it's all about moving stuff over pretty much and algorithms. But yeah, there are algorithms for how to do it. But for these first two steps, they're just really easy. This is four. Okay. First two steps, they're super easy, so you don't need an algorithm for them. So, next up, we have the white corners. This is where you try, and when the white corners are done, all of the white side will be completely white, and it'll be aligned with each side perfectly. All right, so you just do it, and you try and just align it. You just have to try and do some stuff. It took me some time to figure out, but it was pretty easy once I actually got the hang of it. So like here. Here I'm showing you right now. See, I'm trying to get it right there. I first see how I can align it, and then I get it out of the way so that way I can flick it down. Here I can flick it down, like, okay, how can I show you this? All right, here. I need to re-show you this because here, let me see. So you see this one. This right here, it's green and orange, so I have to get this one right here, out of the way, and then I flick this part down. Wait, oh no, did I do that? Yeah, that's okay. Right, so and then I put that one back like this, and then I flip it back up, and bam, that's how you do one part of it. And I don't really need to explain anything else, really, because.
You can just rewatch that part, even though it was terrible. We'll probably add a lot more clarification at the end of each step. Yeah, a ton more clarification, because what I'm doing right now isn't exactly the best explaining as it could be, because I don't have a high quality camera. It's just my laptop camera, pretty much. So hopefully my editing skills will prevail in this, and we will have ourselves a nice video. There we go. That's that part done. And now. And boom!
Done. So that is all that. So, oh yeah. Okay, step three. We're on step three now. You flip it over like this, so that way the yellow is now on top. And what you're trying to do now is you're trying to solve for the middle edges. So like here, let me see, like these two. It's hard to do it. These two, these two. Yeah, shut up. Alright, but there's a specific algorithm to do it, which I'm gonna show you, I think. Was it? But it depends on where it is. So there's two ones to do. So let's hope that we get both of them. Okay. Because you have to do it left or you have to do it right. See how I have it like this? So it has to go towards the blue, which is right here. So I have to make it do the right algorithm, which is what is it? Oh yeah, I know. I pretty much know it by heart, so I can do it like it's. Oh, I should. I'll probably explain at the beginning of the video what each of them mean, but yeah, I'll explain it somehow. I don't know how, honestly. So I go like, actually, I might put it at the end. I don't know, but either way, it doesn't matter. So I go like, I go up inverted, left inverted, up, left, up. Actually, oh no, am I doing this wrong? Up, left, wait, no, that was front, sorry, up inverted, yep, which I did, and then front inverted. So that, oh no, I messed it up. I did left instead of right, oops. So that's how you do it. So I guess I'm showing off this, both of them, fortunately. I honestly did not mean to make that mistake. Okay, so I get back, I know how to do it. If you mess up, there's a way to fix it, but I will have that as another algorithm, because right now I can't explain that. That would be too much. That would literally, it's way too much for me. What the? Oh, it's over there, I forgot. Alright. So yeah, for right, for doing it right, to right side, making it go here, which I should have done, which is my right, by the way, I make it go, how do I do this? Okay, up, right, up inverted, right inverted, up inverted, front inverted, yep, up in, no, just up, and then front, bam, that is perfect. All right, now that I've explained both of them, now, yeah, once I explain both of them, then I pretty much am free to go, and I can just
solve it as quickly as I can. This one's still not the best, so, yeah, the fact that I'm using a bad, like, not the best cube and not the best method and stuff, it makes it, like, I don't really try and keep a time for it. So, yeah, that makes sense. All right, so, okay, I need to get there. I just hope my editing skills will prevail later on. So I did that part.
Oh, just see like this. This is super, super annoying. But, well, at least it was before. But there's a way to solve it. It's just, all right, I might as well just explain it now. It's front inverted. How do I, oh shoot, how do I do it? Oh wait, no, that's for the left side, isn't it? Or the right side? I don't know. Wait. Oh, great. Okay, for me, it's front, oh great, front, up, front inverted, up inverted, left inverted, up inverted, left, and then, oh yeah, then it's done. I'm pretty sure it's done. Yep, there we go. That's how I do it. That's how you undo anything you do. It's, but if it's for right, oh, I'll have to put that in later though, because, I guess I could do it right now. I guess it works. So to do it for the right side, this is how you do it. I have to explain this pretty much, otherwise everyone will have my throats in the comment section. All right, so for doing it to the right way, you have to do it front inverted, up inverted, front. Where is that? There we go. Front. Up. Right. Up. Right inverted. Yep. There we go. And that. I do know this by heart, but I just want to explain this thoroughly, because I just know it by heart, pretty much. Oh boy. Okay, sweet. So I can just solve that now. Sweet. Now, that thing before, it didn't get stuck, it's just, I really wanted to explain that, like, I'm going over this a million times. Okay, we're finally done with that step. It literally took me forever to explain everything, because it takes forever. Alright. So, moving on, we have step 4, which is the yellow cross. So, I want to have this and this. So, it's like the white cross, but it's a lot harder. So, how I get... So, starting off as this, which that's... I have the same algorithm no matter what. So, I do. It's front, right, up, right inverted, up inverted, front inverted. See, now it's like as this. So now if you find it like this, you would make sure it's a backwards L. You find it as a backwards L, which is like this, or oof, or would that be like, that'd be, no, it is a backwards L apparently on my screen, I think. Yeah. So yeah, it's like that. So you keep doing the same method, but you want it lined up correctly. So it would be like, so I have it facing this way, actually speaking. So I do
front, right, up, right inverted, up inverted, front inverted. There we go. Wait, now
it's on the line, the straight line. So either way, it's the same algorithm again. So this can happen naturally. You can just get the cross naturally. I'm literally not joking. Okay, yeah. Okay, let me redo it. Okay, front.
Right, up, right inverted, up inverted, front inverted, yep.
There we go. So now it has the white cross. Now, what's the next step? Oh, yeah, and then next step, it gets a little more tricky from here. It's, you want to line up the edges. Oh, and this is lined up perfectly, because you want these two to be facing it. Like, you want to have the correct, you want to line it up correctly, and then you have it facing where it's like, where is it? Right here, because you want it facing, you want these two corners, you want them facing this way, with, like, oh yeah, to the one of them, so that way one of them is across, and one of them is to the right, and then this is the algorithm you do. It's, here, let me actually get this out. Okay. It's right. Wait, did I get that right? Okay. Here, read it. Right, up, right inverted, up, right, up twice. So, and then right inverted, up. That one's super, it's literally super easy. I don't know how that actually works, though. Like, I don't know. But yeah, now we have this, which, oh, I was going to say if it was actually lined up. So right now, what you want to do is you want to look for corners that are correct placing. So let's look around for them. I feel like Dora the Explorer right now, but there's one right here. But yeah, if you see them, you want to make sure. But if they're all lined up perfectly, which I'll go over in a sec, it's this thing you have to do. But all right, I can flip over the paper I have now. And I can say, this is, I don't know which step this is. This is step 5, I believe. Wait, no, before it was step 5, this is step 6, I'm pretty sure. Alright, so, and alternately, you can skip steps somehow. Like, it's by random chance, pretty much. Like, I did that my first time of solving it. It was funny. Also, because I skipped, like, a ton of steps. But anyways, getting on with it, this is the algorithm you do for step 6, I believe. Okay, so. Up, wait, yeah, up, right, up inverted, left inverted, up, right inverted, up inverted, left. So now the corners are all switched around and all that, but they're still not in the right place. So I have to keep doing it until they're in the right place. All
right. So up, right, up inverted, left inverted. I almost forgot what to do there. Up, right inverted, up inverted, left.
Yeah, they're all lined up. See, even this one. All right, so from there, I want to start going right, or left, left, left. Now, this is the last and final step. This is step 7. So this is the last step that you got to do, which it's, see, I start here, and I start by doing, it's the same thing I do right now. So it's right inverted, down, right, down inverted. Right inverted, down, right, down inverted, right inverted, down, right, down inverted, right inverted, down, right, down inverted. See, now that's like that. So, but what I do now is I go, every time I do it, when I solve a corner, I do up inverted. So, instead of just going like, oh, and just do it like that, but whatever. Okay, so, then we do this again. Right
inverted, down, right, down inverted, right inverted, down, right, down inverted, right inverted, down, right, down inverted, right inverted, down, right, down inverted. Okay, we did that one. We're on the last one. Please, I hope this is right. Okay, right inverted, down, right, down, that was down inverted, right inverted, down, right, down inverted, right inverted, down, right, down inverted, right inverted, down, right, down inverted, and
bam, now we can just go like this. Bam, we solved it. That's all you have to do. Alright. So, thank you guys so much for watching this video of Rubik's Cubes. Hopefully, I'll get the next method in a future video. But anyways, I really hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, then please spam the thumbs up and subscribe to me for some more awesome daily content. And I will see you guys later. Bye!